This is a quick demonstration of cognitive computing capabilities integrated right into JD Edwards Enterprise One. What you see here is an Enterprise One page with the service work order data displayed in the familiar grid format on the left side. This data is being pulled from the same table that the standard service work order application uses. On the right side, we have the JD Edwards Cognitive Assistant. Let me give you some background information on the setup. For this version of the demo, we have connected to the IBM Watson cognitive framework and set of APIs. Additionally, as you know, cognitive systems are useful when there's a lot of data. Instead of creating our own artificial dataset, we decided to tap into the unstructured data on the internet, Stack Exchange. Stack Exchange is a set of expert communities built around social collaboration of people passionate about focused topics. We selected one such active community on Stack Exchange related to the bicycle repair topic and have used the question and answer data generated to train the cognitive backend framework. As part of learning about the bicycle repair topic from these set of questions and answers, the cognitive system used several factors to improve its understanding of the topic as well as differentiate good answers from bad ones. For example, it takes into account how many answers were given for a particular question, how many votes did each answer receive, and also if the original author of the question selected a particular answer as the best one. Enough of the theory, let's see how it works. As a field technician, I'm reviewing my service work orders. Whoa, looks like I have a lot of them. Let me click on the first work order. As you see, as soon as I click on the order, the faded description for that work order gets passed to the assistant to the right, which in turn is now querying the cognitive system via APIs. And it returns back top three results. I can expand the answers to see more details. I can even click on the title to take me to the actual source of data. In this case, the Stack Exchange website. Each of the results have a percentage factor which indicates as to how confident the system is of that particular answer. In here, the system is about 49% confident that the first answer will address what I'm looking for. Which brings me to the next aspect of cognitive systems. Learning based on feedback. There's a check mark against each answer, and I, as a user, can select the answer that did solve my issue. Let's say the first answer did provide the information that I was looking for. So I'll mark that answer. The next time when a similar query is performed, either by me or some other user, the system will provide a higher confidence factor on this answer. Let me show you this learning behavior in action. Initially, when I searched for the failure description, twisted rim, here are the answers that I got. However, over a period of time, the system learned that the description twisted rim and bent rim are highly correlated and can mean similar things. So after that period of learning, here's what the system replied back. When I searched for twisted rim, it had answers related to bent rim included in the top three. And the confidence factor is also a lot higher than the previous case. So far, I have shown you the interaction on an Enterprise One page. The exact same experience is available on the good old Service Work Orders application. The cognitive assistant is set up using a Cafe One layout. As you select a specific service work order in the grid on the left, the contextual failure description details are passed to the cognitive assistant Cafe One frame and off it goes. This is just the beginning. As we explore working with additional data sources, we will be able to train the cognitive system with product manuals, recall information, weather and traffic data, and it will not be only able to make sense of each of those, but also start figuring out relationships between these disparate data sources.